I think the whole point of, or the whole technology of blockchain is because all the transactions are open to the public. It provides transparency and also it's secure. Maybe the users, when they are using the blockchain technology, they know people gonna get their information, and they and. It's actually good for some of the companies to cater to the user behaviors based on their preference. Like, for example, if I use some kind of social apps on the blockchain, right? If I purchase NFTs, maybe I want the platform, whatever I'm using, to cater to my preference and recommending the contents that I like instead of just protecting my privacy. I mean, I know I have an on-chain identity, but people, they don't know who exactly I am. I'm just a portfolio or a profile on the internet. And that on-chain identity maybe is a blockchain version of me. It's another identity, right?
To a degree. So there's a few things to consider here. One is, you know, like, the idea that this, the whole point of blockchain is to be transparent. I think that does miss the point, because I think the point of blockchain, especially in relation to Web3, is not about transparency, it's about empowering the individual. We're taking power and authority away from some centralized entity and spreading it equally across all the community. And so, you know, the I guess the theme here is no longer about like what blockchain is about in terms of like enforcing transparency, but more so about like what can you do to empower the user? Because ultimately, you know, like if you want to bring that sort of democratic environment to the user, then you have to give the user choice. And I think privacy definitely needs to be a choice also. Especially with like your NFT example, right? Like, yeah, sure, some people, you know, especially if you buy like one of the, you know, really fancy NFTs that everyone, you know, has some sort of, understands that there's some sort of reputation involved with it, maybe you do want that to be public. But there are other instances where you may not want it to be public, right? And so like having that optionality of privacy, I think, is extremely important. There's a fallacy regarding your online identity though, because There's two concerns with online identity that kind of arises from the assumption that you're safe because it's a wallet address. One is that you can be doxxed at any time, so anyone can identify you at any point in time. And two is that blockchains are immutable, so they don't change.
Right.
So even if you feel like you're safe today, do you feel like you'll still be safe and anonymous 10 years from now? And if you're not, then whenever you get identified between now and 10 years, people can see exactly what you did today. And so that becomes an issue in terms of your privacy also, right? Because we've all done things on the internet that we regret, right? Like when you're 10 and you're posting on the internet, you're probably not going to be posting the same kind of things when you're 20 or 25 or 30, right? And so like, do you really want all the regrettable stuff completely linked publicly to you? And how does that impact your life, not just in like a personal way, but a professional way?
Right.
How will health insurance companies view you? How will your employers view you? How will your government view you? How will your government's enemies view you? Right? Like, there's a lot of security issues and concerns about how it affects your everyday life if there isn't any sort of privacy. And, you know, just to kind of give a counterexample, once you are identified, and we are talking about, you know, crypto 5-10 years from now,
right?
You go to a coffee shop and you buy a coffee. That coffee transaction shows up on chain. Now, someone else who is monitoring your wallet activity sees that you bought a coffee from this Starbucks in this location. And so they look through your transaction history and they notice that every day at around 8:30 a.m. you go to the Starbucks and you buy a coffee. And so if they wanted to come find you, they would know exactly where to look.
Right. I see your point. Essentially, it's a choice that the users should have on the blockchain.
Definitely.
Whether they want to publicize that information or not.